गुड आफ्टरनून एवरीवन। इन लास्ट लेक्चर्स वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द टू इम्पॉर्टेंट टेस्ट फॉर द स्टेराइल फॉर्मुलेशंस। वन वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द पायरोजेन टेस्ट एंड सेकेंड वन दैट वी हैव डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग द स्टेरिलिटी टेस्टिंग। सो अंडर द स्टेरिलिटी टेस्टिंग वी हैव कवर्ड टू मेन मेथड्स, दैट इज द मेम्ब्रेन फिल्ट्रेशन मेथड एंड सेकेंड मेथड दैट वी हैव डिस्कस्ड रिगार्डिंग द स्टेरिलिटी टेस्टिंग द डायरेक्ट इनोक्युलेशन मेथड। अंडर द पायरोजेन टेस्टिंग we have discussed regarding pyrogen test that we have carried out on albino rabbits that will check the rise in temperature that shows there is some presence of some endotoxic or the toxic materials are present and that materials are pyrogenated, we cannot use for the human being. Apart from that, there is a second one test is there for say to check the pyrogens that the sterile formulations consist any pyrogens or not. This is the in vitro test for the pyrogen has been developed utilizing the chaining property of the lysate of the amebocytes of Humulus polyphemus. That is also crabs are there. So LAL test, Humulus amebocytes lysate test, which is an aqueous extract of blood cells from or the amebocytes from horseshoe crab, or you can call it from the Atlantic horseshoe crabs, Humulus polyphemus. So bacterial endotoxin test, that is basically carried out the amount of endotoxin or for the detections and the quantifications of the bacterial endotoxin which are present in a sterile formulations. So bacterial endotoxin test measures the concentrations of bacterial endotoxin that may be present in the samples using a lysate derivative, the lysate derived from the amebocytes of the horseshoe crab. Name of horseshoe crab, that is a Humulus polyphemus. So Humulus amebocyte lysate test, that is called as a LAL test. So LAL, that is Humulus amebocyte lysate, that will react with the bacterial endotoxin lipopolysaccharides, which is a membrane components of the gram negative bacteria. So what will happen after the additions of the solutions which suppose containing some endotoxin to the solutions? So if you added the solution to this particular LAL reagents, so that lysate produce the turbidity, precipitations or gelations of the mixtures. So in 1956, Fred Band, who has reported that the gram negative bacteria, even if killed, will cause the blood of horseshoe crab to turn into a semi-solid mass. So it was recognized that the animal's blood cells, we call it the amebocytes, which contain some granules with the clotting factors, which is known as a coagulogen. So this is released outside the cell when bacterial endotoxin is occurred, bacterial endotoxin is encountered. So resulting coagulation or the gelling, that they have thought that because of the bacterial infections in the animals, you know, circulatory system. In 1977, US FDA approved the LAL test for testing the drugs, products and devices that comes in contact with the bloods. And as we know, all the sterile formulations that comes directly in contact with the blood, that's why this is the important test that we have to carry out for the sterile formulations. So when they are added your formulations with the LAL reagents, so in the presence of the pyrogenic endotoxin, the gram negative bacteria forms the gels within 16 minutes or when it is incubated for at 37 degrees Celsius. So basically process is very simple. Horseshoe crabs are collected and blood is removed from the horseshoe crab, and the crabs are then returned to the water.
and that Lal reagents that is used for the Lal test that is carried out for the checking the endotoxin, you know, presence of endotoxin or the concentration of the bacterial endotoxins measurement purpose, this particular Lal test is used. So endotoxin limits that is calculated by K by N. What is K? K that is the maximum number of endotoxins which receives the patients without suffering toxic reactions, divided by maximum dose administered to the patients per kg per hour. So that can be used the limit how much amount of means how much amount of endotoxins, how much amount of concentrations of endotoxins can be allowable or is present in that particular formulations. So this is the figure for horseshoe crab. So yachyamadhun tumcha means blood remove kele jatam from the crab's pericardium and then crabs are then returned to the water. Then blood cells are separated from the serum using the centrifugation process and then placed in distilled water. So it will cause them to swell and burst. And after bursting, it will release the chemicals from inside of the cells. It is the lysine, which is then purified by the any one method, and then it will convert it into freeze-dried product. To taste a sample for the endotoxin, this particular lysate mixing with the water. And if endotoxins are present, coagulations will be occurred. A simple test. So horseshoe crab that is used, blood remove kele jate, purna water ne sol jata, tyachya centrifugation carried out karun, purification carried out karun, tyachya madhun te burst hotat ani burst hotle tyachya lysate release hoto. So this is the chemical from the inside of the cell, which is then again purified and then freeze dried. And whenever the test is carried out, they are mixed with the water or the sample. If endotoxins are present, then coagulation, the jelly will be occur. So this is the simple principle behind the Lal test. Lal that is stands for Limulus Amebocytes Lysate test. So it will be 5 to 10 times more sensitive than the rapid test. So why to carry out this endotoxin test? Because endotoxin test which is carried out to protect against the adverse reactions in humans and animals, mostly FDA and USP guidelines require the final product testing on all the parenteral and medical devices. As I have already discussed, in 1977, the US FDA approved the Lal test for drug products and devices that comes in contact with the blood. So before that, only the rabbit test which is carried out to check the pathogenicity of that particular population. But now, in 1977, this is the compulsory test for those products who have come in direct contact with blood. Thirdly, to safeguard against the diminished effectiveness of the product due to endotoxins, just now we have discussed, suppose if any endotoxins are present, there may be coagulations will occur. So we can, if there may be the chances of changing the effectiveness of our product, so that can be overcome in this particular endotoxin test. What is endotoxicity? So endotoxin, it causes the myeloid tissue to release inflammatory mediators. Cytokines induce a variety of tissue damage, shock, and multiple organ dysfunctions may occur. But this under the endotoxicity. To avoid all this particular endotoxin test has to be carried out. So this is a simple mechanism. Just now we have discussed. The test is based on a primitive blood clotting mechanism of the horseshoe crab. We have discussed already how the lysate is removed from the horseshoe crabs. So blood is removed from the pericardium of the horseshoe crabs. Then blood cells are separated from the serum using the centrifugation process. and then it is placed in a distilled water, which will cause them to swell. And after swelling, means after bursting, from the inside of the cell, the lysate which is released, the chemical that is released, which is then purified and presented, and the test is carried out. Now the enzyme located within the crabs, oocytes, blood cells, we are removing the endotoxin. So there is one clotting factors known as a coagulation. So mobile cells we have called as the amebocytes, and those endotoxins which are present. So those amebocytes which containing the granules with the clotting factors known as a coagulation, and this release the bacterial endotoxins and resulting the coagulation of the gene. So initiation of the enzymatic coagulation cascades with our sample solutions, and if any endotoxins are present, the gel will be formed. It is a simple method. Whatever the lal reagents are there, that you have to treat it with the sample solutions, and you have to incubate them for the specific time durations, and the result you have to interpret. So there are three basic methods: gel clotting technique, turbidimetric techniques, and a chromogenic techniques are there. So here, how to remove the lal reagent? Basically, it was to collect the blood of horseshoe crabs from the pericardium. So bleeding adult crabs blood into an anti-clotting solutions. Then we have to wash and centrifuge to collect the amebocytes. After that, which is placed in a water or in a 3% NaCl solution, lysing will be the lysing, that means bursting. And after the bursting, what will happen here? So because of the NaCl solutions, which causes them to swell, causes amebocytes to swell, and they will burst, and after that they release the chemical from the inside of the cells. This lysate, it is washed with water and freeze dried or lyophilized for the storage purpose. So now here we get our lal reagents. What is lal? Stands for limulus amebocytes lysate. Is lal. So the procedure is very simple. We have to take the equal volume of the lal reagents and the test solutions, which was 0.1 ml of each. They are mixed in a depyrogenated test tube. So the whatever the test tube that we are using, that must be pyrogen free, properly sterilized, and then we can use for the lal test. Then we have to incubate them at 37 degrees Celsius for 1 hour. Then you have to remove the test tube from the incubators and invert in one smooth motions. Means 180 degree you have to and you have to observe the result. So there are three different techniques are there that can be used for the used to check the lal test. So first, that is the gel clotting techniques. Second one, the turbidimetric techniques, and third one, the chromogenic techniques. So what happens in a gel clotting techniques? A solid gel is formed in the presence of the endotoxin. So that is a simple process that we have seen previously. So this test requires positive as well as a negative control. Positive control, that for a known concentrations of endotoxin which is added to the lysate solutions, and the negative controls means water and the preform endotoxin solution that is added to the Raynaud's solution. That will be negative controls, and we have to check, we have to interpret the result here. Observe the result, whether there is a coagulation speed occurs or whether there is a precipitation is occurs or not. That we have to observe in the gel clotting techniques. Then the other advantages, there is no equipment, low equipment cost, historical test method, so FDA referred this test, as we already discussed in 1977, this test is referred. Sample color does not interfere with the assay. But here the disadvantage is sensitivity of this test is very low, which is sensitive to the 0.015 European unit per ml. So require validations and reference test assays. Limited quantitations are there and mostly prone to the analyst error. So observer must be proper there. Then second one is the turbidimetry test. So in the turbidimetry test, turbidity is measured. So this test is based on the measurement of opacity change due to the formations of insoluble coagulant. We have already discussed there is a one coagulation agents are there. We call as the clotting factors are there, which is called as the coagulation. So this particular turbidimetric technique is measure the opacity which is changed due to the formations of the coagulants or the formation of the jelly. So this opacity is directly proportional to the endotoxin concentrations. जेवढं तुमचं endotoxin, जेवढं तुमची opacity high असणार आहे तेवढं तुमचं endotoxin concentration त्याचं directly proportional असणार आहे. So basically this technique is used for the water systems and simple pharmaceutical products. So to check the opacity change. Then chromogenic techniques is there. Chromo is the color. So this is based on the measurement of color change which is caused by the release of chromogenic chemicals. So mostly para nitroanilids that is used, so which modify the lysates with the yellow color. So now the quantity of para nitroanilid which is required or produced is directly proportional to the endotoxin concentration. So the three, these are the three methods that can be used for the carried out bacterial endotoxin test. So like a pyrogen testing, this is one of the important test for the sterile formulation. It is a bacterial endotoxin test which is carried out with the help of the horseshoe crab, Atlantic horseshoe crabs, yes, Atlantic horseshoe crabs. We have removed the blood from that crabs and we are checking the endotoxin concentrations in a specific samples. Now another one important test is there, that is a particulate count test. So particulate testing for the particulate matters, which is the primary concern in the parenteral products given by the IV routes or any routes. That should be, means all the parenteral formulations should be free from the insoluble particles. We have seen there are various GMP procedures are there to carry it out, to fill the containers, and then we have to check the containers after the filling. We have to check all the containers. So USP state that you are United States Pharmacopeia that state that you have to check all the containers by visually inspected, and then and that with the visible particle be discarded. Suppose it was a counterfeit particle, visible particles as thing, so the container is disposed of. But other tests are carried out that we are selecting some samples for the testing purpose. But for the particulate evaluation test, we have taken all the packed containers. So the visual inspection is carried out to carry out the particulate evaluations. So we have no erythrocytes have a diameters of approximately 4.5 micron, and particles of more than 5 micron should be the basis for these evaluations. So that particulates has to be identified and we have to remove them. So the unaided eye means like open eye can see the particle approximately 50 micron, so 10 micron particles can be seen by the light scattered from them.
So the visual inspection is done by holding the ampules by its necks against the highly illuminated screens.
So there are two partitions are there, white screen and a black screen. So white screens for the detection of the black particles and black screen for the detection of the white particles. To detect the heavy particles, sometimes we have to invert the containers, but care must be taken to avoid the bubbles here, because we cannot remove the excess bubbles at the end of the evaluation. So little simple methods are there.
So particulate matters means what? So those are the extraneous matters are there, mobile phase are there, individual particles are there. Those are other than gas bubbles, which are unintentionally present in the solution, which are called as a particulate matters. So asa kontehi goshta ki ji tumcha formulations madhe present ahe, so that we have to identify, and if any particulate matters is present in a containers, then we have to discard that containers.
So what is the procedures here? So as already I have discussed, USP guidelines have provided that full batch inspections must be there. It's not like that you can just take 10 to 20 samples from the total batch and you can say that all these particular batch are free from the particulate count. No, we have to carry out the 100% batch inspections for your particulate evaluation purpose. So it is called a clarity test also. So clarity, that is a relative term, that meanings of which is markedly affected by the subjective evaluations of the observer. So it is practically impossible to prepare a lot of sterile products so that every unit of that lot is perfectly free from the visible particulate matters. So it is responsibility of the quality control department to detect and discard individual containers of the products that the ultimate users would consider to be unclean. So further, USP state that the good pharmaceutical practices require that all the containers be visually inspected and that any with visible particles will be discarded. So although particulate matter is primary concerns in the products which given the intravenously, all parental products should be free from the insoluble particles. So in several years ago it was shown that the information of the pathological granulomas in vital organs of the body can be traced, the fibers, rubber fragments and other solid presents in IV solutions. Recently double blind study has been shown that the use of the final filter for the administrations of the IV solutions reduce the incidence of the thrombophlebitis, which is the result believed to be due to the emission of the subvisual particles from the administered solutions. So while there are some unanswered questions which is related to toxic effects, so these are in going process. So to carry out this, means the visual inspections of the product container is usually carried out by the human. So there are two sections are there, as already I have discussed. Like here we can see there are two panels are there. One is your matte black panels and here the white panel is there. So here what will happen, the visual inspection is done by holding the ampule by its neck against this particular screen. So white screen, this is for the detections of black particles, and the black screen or the black panel, this is used for the detections of white particles. So this is adjustable lamp holder, mostly neon tube or the white illuminating tube that is used, so that reflections will be properly carried out and we can detect any particles are present in that particular containers, and if any particles are there, so it can be discarded totally. There are another tests are also there, light absorption tests are there, light absorption particle count test is there. So it's a suitable apparatus
is based on the principle of light block. Suppose any particles are there, so that light will be blocked here. So which allows an automatic determinations of the size of the particle and the number of particles according to the size. So basically like a light scattering techniques that is used. So it is with the instrumental methods. You could utilizing the principle of light scattering or the light absorptions and electric resistance that has been used to obtain the particle counts and the size of distributions. A shadow cast by the particle as it is passed through the highly intensity light beam. So therefore the particles are still, so the particle abstract with the curvature, light block kill the detectors detectors directly particle size and amount of particles that is determined that they are determined. So mix the contents, the sample, by slowly inverting the containers 20 times successfully. If necessary, cautiously remove the sealing closures. Clean the outer surface of the containers opening using a jet of particle free waters and remove the closures and avoiding any contaminations of the content. So for large volume parenterals, single units are used or single units are tested. For small volume parenterals less than 25 ml which contains 10 or more units are combined in clean containers to obtain a volume which is not less than 25 ml. Or diluting to 25 ml with the particle free water or with appropriate particle free solvent. Suppose the powder for the parenterals are used for the reconstituted with the particle free water with an appropriate particle free solvent, then solvent is subjected for the testing purpose. Then microscopic particle count tests are there. The sample is filtered through the membrane under the ultra clean conditions, then that is placed under the suitable binocular microscope. And we have to count the number of particles that are equal to or greater than 10 micron size and the number of particles that are equal to or greater than the 25 micron size. That we have carried out for the suspension, determine the particle size for the suspension in third year, where we can carry out the microscopic method. So same methods we have added for the particle count test. We have to measure the, to first calibrate the eyepiece micrometers and stage micrometers, and after that, after calibrations, we have to measure the particles which are present in the sample after the filtrations, and we have to measure how much particles are there which are equal to or more than 10 micron size and how much particles are there that is equal to or more than 25 micron size. So that gives the microscopic particulate count test. Now the last test that we are going to discuss, that is the leak test or the leaker test. So basically leak test the leak test is intended to detect the whether there is an incomplete sealing of the ampoules are there, so we can be discard them. There are two methods by which ampoules are sealed, like a tip seal method and the pulling method. So in that testing, the tip seal method, the tip seal ampoules are more prone to the leak than the pull sealing method. So suppose there are some cracks present around the seals also, or the base of the ampoules also, so because of the improper handling. So these particular leakers are there, leaker testers are there, that usually detect by producing the negative pressures within the incompletely sealed ampoules using into the vacuum chambers. So here we are using one dye solutions, mostly methylene blue, 0.5 or 1% methylene blue dye solutions are used. Then vials and bottles are not subjected to such leaker test because rubber process is not rigid. So mostly ampoules are there. So these ampoules are intended to provide a hermetically sealed container for the single dose or the products. So the precautions has to be taken that it should not be cracks during the transport or anything. So because of sometimes change in temperatures during the storage, it will cause the expansions and contractions of the ampoules also and the contents. So there may be chances of cracking will be there. So the leak test is basically intended to detect the incomplete sealed ampoules so that we can discard it. So for ampoules, is intended to detect the incompletely sealed ampoules. So as already discussed, keep seals and pull seals, these are the two methods are there for the sealing purpose that we are going to actually perform in the practicals. So tip seals are more likely to be incompletely closed by the pull sealing methods. So there may be chances of the open capillaries or some cracks at the point of the seal, which will causes the leak the ampoules. So this particular detection of the leaker is prominent when the ampoules immerse in a bath of dye. We are mostly using methylene blue solutions during the autoclaving cycle. So this has the advantage of accomplishing both leaker detections as well as the sterilizations in operation. So basically what the procedures is, the simple procedures is there. So this is the leak test apparatus. At a the negative pressure generate kela jato and negative pressure generate karun tumcha vertically thevlela ampoules ahe tyachyamade to jo kai methylene glue hai negative pressure generate zalyamule jar kute cracks astil tar te cracks madhe tumcha methylene glue ha tumcha containers madhe kiwa tya ampoules madhe in honar ahe ani apan identify karu shakto ki to particular ampoules kudhe tari break hai kiwa tyachyamade kai tari fault hai. So here the procedures is very simple. We have to seal the ampoules, we have to place the ampoules in a vacuum chambers, we have to completely submerge in a deep colored methylene blue solutions. 0.5 to 1% methylene blue solutions are used. Now we have to apply the negative pressures within the ampoules with subsequent atmospheric pressures. We have seen this is the leaker test chambers are there where negative pressure is generated, which will causes the dye to penetrate an openings, and that can be visible after the ampoules has been washed. Means simple process ahe apan jeva lab madhe perform karna tasha madhe simple process apan kay carry out karto methylene blue solutions ghetto beaker madhe je apan ampoules seal kelat त्या सगळ्या ampoules त्या बीकर मध्ये प्लेस केल्या जातात, त्या पूर्ण डीप केल्या जातात इथिलीन ब्लू सोल्यूशन्स मध्ये अँड ॲट द एंड त्याला ऑटोक्लेविंग केलं जातं. ऑटोक्लेविंग करून 121 डिग्री सेल्सियस 30 मिनिट्स पर्यंत ठेवलं जातं आणि मग ते रिमूव्ह करून, कारण निगेटिव्ह प्रेशर जनरेट झाल्यामुळे तो जो काही डाय सोल्यूशन्स आहे इथिलीन ब्लूचं जर कुठे तुमचं लीक असेल तर ते त्या पर्टिक्युलर त्या लीक ampoules मध्ये तो इथिलीन ब्लू तुमचा एंटर होतो, त्यामुळे जे तुमचं क्लिअर सोल्युशन असतं, कारण आपण मोस्टली बघितले मोस्टली जे इंजेक्शन आहेत दे आर इन अ क्लिअर सोल्युशन, सो ते कुठेतरी ब्ल्यूश कलर होतं. तर तुमचं ब्ल्यूश कलरचं जर झालं दॅट मीन्स त्या पर्टिक्युलर ऍम्प्युल्स मध्ये कुठेतरी लिकेज आहे, कुठेतरी क्रॅक्स आहेत, त्याच्यामधून तुमचं मिथिलीन ब्ल्यू सोल्युशन हे एंटर झालं. सो ते आफ्टर रिमूव्हिंग फ्रॉम द ऑटोक्लेव वी हॅव टू वॉश दॅट ऍम्प्युल्स अँड वी हॅव टू चेक दॅट वेदर एनी cracks or any openings are there in that particular ampoules. So this is the representative samples we have to select and we have to check the leaker test. So what are the drawbacks? So capillaries of 1.5 microns or similar diameters cannot be detected by this test. Vials and bottles are not subjected to such a leaker test as a rubber closures is not as rigid. So the simple tests are there. The seal ampoules are subjected to the small cracks which occurs to rapid temperature change or due to the mechanical shocks. So to feel and seal the ampoules, dip in 1% methylene blue solutions under the negative pressures in the vacuum chambers. Then vacuum is released. Colored solutions enter into the ampoules. Then it is a defective sealing. Then our sealing properly done. So this is all regarding the tests or the quality control tests which are carried out for the parenteral formulations. There are four important tests are there. Sterility testing. So sterility testing that will be carried out by two methods: membrane filtration method and direct inoculations method, where we are using the two digestive media, fluid dioglycolate medium and casein digestive. Soybean casein digestive medium. Then pyrogen endotoxin test. Pyrogen test, again two tests are there. One test that is the rabbit test, second one that is the lard test or the bacterial endotoxin test,
which is called large test, that is stands for the lumulus amebocyte lysate test and the rabbit test, where we are checking the temperatures rise because of the presence of the pyrogens will be there. Then particular evaluations are there, means to check the clarity of formulations against the white and the black backgrounds with the help of the specified light, to check the number of particulates presents in containers. If any particulates is present, we have to discard them, and this particular particulate evaluation test we have to perform 100% on total batch here. And then the liquor test comes. So liquor test to check the whether to check the leak, to detect the incomplete sealing of ampoules, so that we can, they can be that particular incomplete sealed ampoules, we can discard them. So this is all regarding the quality control test and the quality assurance of the parenteral formulations, as well as we have completed our first topic, that is sterile product. In next lectures we'll start with the ophthalmic formulations. Okay, thank you. We'll stop here.